When people are using the 2050 Pathways Calculator tool to explore the different ways our energy system might develop, they often ask, so, what will it cost? We've started to try and answer this question. We probably haven't got it right yet, so we'd appreciate your feedback and help in making it better. Okay, so here is my pathway. What does it cost? I go to the See Implications menu and choose Costs in Context. In this case, I see that my pathway costs an average of £4,000 per person per year from now to 2050. But what does that mean? The first thing to mention is that it doesn't mean that our energy bills would be £4,000 per person per year. This is the cost to society, and it includes all sorts of things that you may not think about as part of your energy bill. On top of the gas and electricity you would use at home, it includes the cost of your car and the petrol that you would put in it, the cost of your central heating system, the cost of trains, the cost of heating the place you would work and the places you would shop, and so on. We've tried to include the cost of everything that you can vary in the calculator. The second thing to mention is that some things that you pay for aren't included because they just move money around society. That includes the profits the companies make, the subsidies that you receive, and the taxes that you pay. The third thing to mention is that some things have a cost, but you don't pay for it in cash, and so at the moment, they aren't included in this number. That includes the cost of being colder, of travelling less, of waiting for a bus, of a less pleasing view if you happen to think that wind turbines look ugly, and the cost of failing to tackle climate change. On that last point, if you believe the Stern Review, then the worst case would be a global reduction in GDP of 20% if we didn't tackle climate change. Translating that into a cash cost for the UK is awkward, but 20% of the forecast GDP between now and 2050 would be about £6,500 per person per year, and you would add this to the cost of your energy system. Okay, this number is not your energy bill, so how could you think about it? We've tried to help you by giving you some context. The first piece of context is that there is no such thing as a free lunch. Powering the economy will always cost something. If you think the alternative to my pathway is this pathway here, where we don't tackle climate change or energy security and become ever more dependent on natural gas, then it might still cost £4,700 per person per year to power the UK economy. Therefore, in some senses, it is the additional cost of pathways that matter, and these are marked with the red labels against the red axes. In this case, my pathway could actually be cheaper than a choice that doesn't tackle climate change. However, my pathway may have features that you consider undesirable. For instance, perhaps you object to my use of nuclear power, or think that I am unrealistic in expecting people to turn down their thermostats. So to help you with your decision, we've presented a range of different pathways that have different features. Some have nuclear, some do not. Some have higher energy efficiency, some have lower. These pathways vary in cost, but when you consider them in the context of the size of the economy, which is bounded by the right-hand side of this scale, and the differences are not huge, and you may consider that it is worth paying a little bit extra. But what is the source of these extra costs? We've given you some tools to explore. If you click on a bar, we zoom in and you can see what contributes to the different costs. Leftmost is fossil fuels, then bioenergy, then electricity, and so on. You may be surprised that transport is such a big element. This is because we include the full cost of all the cars, vans, buses, trucks, trains, and planes in the UK. We included the full cost because you can choose to travel less and to travel differently. So we needed to accurately reflect the potential savings from, for instance, requiring fewer cars, if you think that fewer cars is a sensible thing to have. If you click one more time, you can zoom in again and see, for instance, the variation in the cost of nuclear power across the pathways. This variation is caused by different user choices about how much nuclear should be built. The calculator is simplistic. If you choose to build nuclear, then it builds nuclear and it shows you the cost. So if I select level 4 nuclear, the costs go up, even though I don't actually need any more nuclear power. It doesn't cost optimize in any sense. In practice, of course, we might choose to have more nuclear if it turned out to be cheap, and less if it turned out to be expensive. Or we might not. We might never want nuclear, however cheap it is. Or we might always want nuclear, however expensive it gets. In either case, we might want to explore the different possible costs of nuclear power. We can do this by choosing cost sensitivity from the See Implications dropdown. On this screen, I now see the cost of my pathway in blue and the cost of the pathway that I'm comparing with in red. In this case, I'm comparing with a pathway that doesn't tackle climate change. I could use this dropdown here to compare with a pathway that doesn't use much nuclear, for instance, like so. I then see the difference in cost between the two pathways here. Moving down the screen, we have a bar chart of all the different components that contribute to these cost totals, ranked in order of size. In each case, the blue is the cost in my pathway, and the red is in the cost of the pathway that I'm comparing with. And the black arrow shows the range of cost estimates for that technology. We can see that for both pathways, the cost of conventional cars, of electric vehicles, of oil, of heating are similar. However, the costs of nuclear power, of wind, of insulation, and of fuel cell vehicles differ. We can then use these buttons on the right-hand side to explore what happens if things turn out to be cheap or expensive. So if nuclear power turns out to be expensive, then some of the benefit of my pathway is wiped out. If wind turns out to be cheap, then some more of the benefit of my pathway is eliminated. And so on until we discover situations where my pathway might not be cheaper after all. In each case, we've tried to make the cheap value the lowest credible estimate that we have found so far. We've tried to make the default value match the value that has been used in the more sophisticated Markow energy model that DEC has used as part of its carbon plan analysis. We've tried to make the expensive value be either the highest price forecast in the case of oil prices or gas prices, or the price of a good today in the case of wind turbines and electric vehicles. You can see what we've actually assumed by clicking on the See Assumptions label. This takes you to our wiki that explains our methodology for that sector, and then from there you can see the individual cost points that we've discovered so far. From the wiki, you can also download the Excel version of the 2050 Pathways calculator. This includes everything that we've assumed and all the formulas that we've used to calculate the results that you see. It also allows you to see the results in different units and with different discount and finance rate assumptions. And it allows you to try out your own cost assumptions to see what difference they make. You can see everything that we have. Are aware that we probably haven't got this tool right yet. We expect that you might have views on our presentation, on our methodology, on our formulas, and on the assumptions we're making about the costs of different technologies. We would really value your feedback so we can make this tool better. Please take a look at the wiki, add cost data points, and comment on our methodology. Please download the Excel spreadsheet and propose enhancements. Please play with this front end and tell us about bugs. We value your help in creating a useful tool for everyone.